especially for this evening. Judith Bernstein's gigantic screws take revenge upon the male use of female bodies in art. Do we males now know how it feels to be exploited? Furthermore, give or take a few Amazons, Bernstein uncovers war as a male metaphor, a deadly metaphor that we cannot seem to get rid of. Are women, and indeed other men, more attracted to men who are fighters and killers, and therefore perhaps more easily seen as protectors or, in the case of males, role models and heroes, than to males who can negotiate with enemies or can outsmart them? Although this is not a question Bernstein addresses, never mind the answers, we do not want to make the mistake of blaming the victims, do we? Along with the psychosexual genesis of mass death, Bernstein is also addressing the less loaded issue of scale in art by making it visual. Big scale equals big penis. Her work ironically becomes what it attacks. We want to look away, but we can't. Bernstein opens up the abyss of the unthinkable. Unfortunately, war is still with us. Fortunately, sex is still with us, but unfortunately, sexism is still with us. Recently, I looked up on the Gorilla Girls website, which I recommend to you. I myself am an honorary Gorilla Girl, and somewhere I have a certificate to prove it. The Gorilla Girls have been active at least since 1985. And I'm sure you all know the good work that they do. But on their website, they have a very interesting statistic that I thought I would share with you, that Eli Broad and the Broad Art Museum at LACMA, the collection that's there now is 97% white artists, 87% males. I don't think that's much of an improvement since 1985. In his own collection, it's a little bit better. Instead of 97% males, it's 96% males. So you see, there's work for other girls. It's never over.
So, Judith.
I don't know where should we begin here. Is this going to be chronological or
not? Well, actually, it goes all over the place. It starts out this. This was the first show I had at AIR Gallery in 1973, October 1st. And I did these very, very large drawings, which obviously it's an understatement, of the combination of screws and penises, these large cocks. So they were a metaphor, and they were drawings that were done in my studio. My studio is not as large as but I did part of them, scrolled it up, did more, scrolled it down. There are multiple metaphors. And scale is a big factor in terms of that. And I signed the back one, which you can see, Judith Bernstein, really large. So I wanted people to know that a woman had done it, and it really was a comment on the guys. My work is actually, it's a comment, but it's not really, my work is not that ironic. It has a drop of it, but not that much. This was actually, as I said, the first show that AIR, the first one-person show. Before that, AIR had shows that were two-person shows. So this was the first one after that. We started in 1972 because many of us could not get shows and gallery presentation. We started in Soho. There were two women, Margaret Zucker, as well as Susan Williams. Good. I'm glad I'm getting some audience participation here. Susan Williams. And then they got together with Dottie Addy, as well as Mary Floriatis. They went to a lot of studios. And they basically used, Lucy Lippard had a file. And she had all many, many women that were on file, and that was picked up. They couldn't figure out actually what. plot, 20 women artists together. But that did not work out. In this case, too, I was ahead of March Klein. But anyway, they did call it AIR, which was good because there was a lot of, it was a feminism was in the air. And it was also AIR, Artist in Residence, was in a lot of law, so we all knew what that was about. Anyway,
for those who don't know, the AIR side came about as a kind of compromise to allow, as I remember, to allow artists to reuse some of the unused laws. And it was, so the fire department could determine that there was someone in the law if there was some kind of emergency.
That absolutely.
So it was Artist in Residence, and so they would know to send a ladder up and rescue them.
It didn't come to that, but just me. We'll have the next slide, great. So as you get into the space, another giant cock here, can't get enough in my estimation. We have a large groin on the left, as well as a large one inside. And they are really a combination of screws and phalluses.
Could you give us a better idea of the scale?
Oh, sure.
Is it like a third of that wall?
No, I would say it's in terms of the wall that we're talking about over here, it would be about almost the whole wall, I would say, from the back all the way to this one. It's 26 feet. This is a long wall. This is about 40-something. But anyway, this the one on the right, the larger one, is 26 feet long and 9 feet high. And the one on the right is 12.5 by 9 feet. So size matters. It also dwarfs the individual, and you become involved with this enormous presence.
Technical question.
Oh, okay. This one is a detail of the one you just saw.
So these are dyes with
charcoal. Yes, these are all charcoal paper. Yeah, and it's funny because they're such large presences, but yet they the medium itself is very fragile.
Do you have archival issues?
You know something, it depends. Most of them have worked out really well, some not as well. The ones that were shown a lot, not quite as much, but the ones that were not shown at all, or shown one or two times, were really just pristine, quite pristine. This one has only been shown this time at AIR, so I haven't seen it since then. Still in my place, but I haven't seen it.
So they don't keep plexiglass or anything like that. If I were in the same direction, we're going to do a big show on these.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm so glad you said that, yes.
It's a great time to be in a museum director.
Absolutely.
So when I become, definitely go out there and check out your show.
Absolutely.
And my preparator will say, we can't have these drawings out there in the public or on brush against the charcoal.
I say, let them brush against it. These are actually fixed so that even if you brush against it, it would be okay. But they are, they're fragile because they're paper, but they've held up really well. And paper has a nice patina sometimes, so sometimes the paper can get a little bit of a yellowing and stuff like that, but they seem to have held it very well. This one was a piece that was censored in Philadelphia in 1974. And it was part of a show that was called Women's Work, but I have to say I don't like that title that much. But anyway, it was called Women's Work, and Lila Katzen, Marsha Tucker, Cindy Nebzer, the Star Journal, Ann Donningcourt, Philadelphia Museum, and Adeline Rieskin were part of this, and they organized the show. And this show created a lot of controversy because of the fact that it was so phallic, and the director of this